Hi guys, welcome back to the new video of Easy Tutorials. And today in this video you will see how to create a website using HTML and CSS. As you can see on my computer screen, here is the web page that I will create in this video. First you can see we have one logo, then navigation menu. In the right side you can see this attractive button. Then we have title and subtitle and one more button with gradient border. In the right side you can see one image. And in the right bottom you can see this social media icon, and in the left bottom you can see some other icons with gradient background color. So you will learn to create this beautiful web page using HTML and CSS. So before starting this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe if you are new on my channel. Now let's start this video. So first you can see I have one folder here, and in this folder I have two images and one HTML file and one CSS file. Now I will open my text editor, which is brackets editor. So this is my HTML file. I have already written basic HTML structures. This one is CSS file. You can see I have already connected HTML file with CSS with this line of code. Now we will come to the body tag, and here we will create one div, and I am writing the class name container. Just copy this class name container and come to the CSS file, write it here, and for this one we will write width, it will be 100%, and height also 100%. Background, we will add one color in background. Save these changes, then open the HTML file with Google Chrome. Now you can see this dark background color on this web page. Let's come back to the HTML file again, and here we will create one more div, and the class name I am writing menu. Now we'll add some list, so I am using UL then LI. So in this list I will add home, then duplicate it. So the second one is services. Now the third one, product, and the next one is contact. Just save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see all these lists in the left corner. Just copy this class name menu, write it into the CSS file, then write UL. Display, it will be inline flex. Then margin 50 pixel. Just duplicate it, then write LI. Let me remove this one. Here we will add list style none, and margin it will be 0 and 20 pixel. Let's add one color, and cursor will be pointer. Save these changes and reload the web page. You can see this menu over here, it is aligned in the horizontal line. Next, come to the HTML file, and here we will add logo. So simply duplicate this one, and here we will add image. So I am adding img, src and the image file name. Let me add one class name here. So I am adding class name logo. Let's copy this class name and come to the CSS file, write it here, then write img. So here we will write width 30 pixel for this logo. Reload the web page, and you can see this logo over here. Now again come back here, and here I will add margin top minus 7 pixel and margin right 48 pixel. Save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see some space around this logo. Next we have to change the color of first menu. So come back to the HTML file, and here we will add one class name, and the class name I am writing active. Just copy this active class name and come to the CSS file, write it here, and here we will set color some different color. So after reloading this page you can see the first menu color is different from others. Now I have to add one button in the right side, so come back to the HTML file and duplicate this last one, contact. And here I will add sign up. Now we'll add one anchor tag here. So I'm writing a href. And we'll add one class name also. So the class name is signupBTN. Just copy this class name and come to the CSS file, write it here. So for this one, we will add top 40 pixel, right, 80 pixel, position absolute, text decoration none, and color white. Save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see this text in the right side. Now come back in the CSS file and here we will add border 2 pixel, solid and transparent. Border radius, it will be 20 pixel. And background image, this will be linear gradient. Then I will write radial gradient also. Then background origin, border box, and background clip, it will be content box and border box. Reload this web page and you can see this gradient border for this link. Now we have to add some space around this border. So come back to the HTML file and here we will add span, open and close it here. Now come back to the CSS file, just copy this one, write it here, then write span. Now we'll add display block and let's add padding 8 pixel, 22 pixel. Reload the web page and you can see a beautiful button in the right side. Now we have to add some text on this web page. So come back to the HTML file and after this div we'll create another div and the class name I'm using banner. Let's add one more div here. This will be for left column. So class name I'm writing app text. And in this div we will add one title. So I'm using h1. So this is the title. Now we'll add some text, so I'm using p tag. So this is our small description in p tag. Save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see this title and a small description over this web page. Here we will add br to change the line and in description also. Again reload the web page and you can see a small width for this content. Let's copy this class name banner and come to the CSS file. So for this banner we will write width 80%, height 70%, top 25%, left 130 pixel and position absolute, color white. So after reloading this page you can see this white color text and some space from left side. Now we'll copy this class name app text, write it here, and for this one we'll write width 50% and float left. Let's duplicate it, then write h1 for this title. So font size it will be 43 pixel and width 640 pixel and position relative. Margin left 40 pixel. Reload the web page and you can see increased font size for this text. Now come back and duplicate it, then write p. Remove all these things. Here we will add width 650 pixel, font size 15 pixel, margin 30 pixel 0, 30 pixel and 40 pixel. Line height, it will be 25 pixel. Color, this one. Reload the web page and you can see this text in a small font size. Now we'll create one more div here, and the class name I'm using app picture for the right column. And here we'll add one image, so I'm using img src and the image file name. Let's copy this class name, write it here. And here we will write width 50%, float right. Now duplicate this one, then write img. And here we will write width 100%. Save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see this image in the right column. Now come back to the CSS file, and here we will add margin top minus 20 pixel. Then padding left 50 pixel. Reload the web page and you can see proper alignment for this image. Now we will add one more button in the left column. So come back to the HTML file, and after this p tag we will add div, and class name I'm using playBTN. Next we'll add one more div, and this class name I'm using playBTN inner. Now we have to add one icon here. For that we need font awesome icon. So come to the Google and search for font awesome CDN. Open this link and just copy this URL. Come back to the HTML file and duplicate this line, and instead of style.css just paste this URL that you have copied. That's it. Now again come to the Google and search for font awesome icons. Open this website, and here you can find lots of icons for your website. So here I will search for play. So this is the play icon, just click on this one. Now copy this one line of code and add it here. We can remove this part. That's it. Save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see this play icon over here, which is very small. Now just copy this class name and write it into the CSS file. So for this one we'll add margin left 40 pixel, display inline flex. Reload the web page. Now you can see proper space from left side. Let's come back and copy this class name. Write it here. And for this one we will add height 50 pixel, width 50 pixel. Now just come back to the previous button, just copy everything and paste it here. Here we will write border radius 50%. That's it. Save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see this circle over here with gradient color. Come back in the CSS file and copy this one. Then write .fa for icon. So let's add padding 18 pixel 0. And font size, it will be 13 pixel, and cursor pointer. And here we will add text align center. Reload the web page, and now you can see this icon in this circle. So it looks very beautiful button. After this icon we will add one text. So I'm using small. Then I'm adding B, and the text is learn more. Save these changes and reload the web page. You can see this text over here. So just copy this one, small, and write it here. So for this one, we will add margin auto 20 pixel and cursor pointer. Font size, it will be 12 pixel. And this color, then letter spacing 3 pixel. Reload the web page and you can see this text over here. It is looking very beautiful. Next, we will add some icon in the left corner. So after this div, we'll create another div and the class name I'm using quick links. Here we will add some list. So I'm using UL then LI. Now we have to add one icon. So just copy this one and paste it here. Then we'll add one text also. So I'm using P and the text is share to. Let me change the icon. So this one will be share icon. Let's duplicate this one. And the second icon is this one. Let's change the second text also. Now change the third icon. And this is the text. And this is the fourth icon. And this is the text for fourth menu. Reload the web page and you can see all these icons and text in the left side, which is in black color. So just copy this class name quick links, write it into the CSS file. And for this one, we'll add left 0 and bottom 0. Position, it will be absolute. And background, here we'll add linear gradient background color. Save these changes and reload the web page. Now you can see all this content in the left bottom corner with background color. Let's copy it again. Then write UL. So for this one, we'll write display inline flex. Then margin 25 pixel auto. Text align center. Just duplicate it again. Then write LI. Remove this one. And here we will add list style none, margin 0, 50 pixel, cursor pointer. Reload the web page and you can see all this content in the horizontal style. Next, we will increase the height of this box. So come back to the CSS file and here we will change it to 30 pixel. Now you can see increased height. Next, we will change the color for icon. So just copy this one, then write .fa. So here we will add font size. It will be 25 pixel. Next, we will write color, white color. Reload the web page and you can see all these icons in white color. Next, we will write the code for this text. So just copy it again, then write P. Here we will add margin top 15 pixel and font size 10 pixel and color white. Reload the web page and you can see this white color for this text also. Now it is looking very beautiful. Next, we will add social media icon in the right bottom corner. So come back to the HTML file again and after this div, we will create one more div. And class name I'm using social icons. Again, we will create UL and LI. Next, we will add one anchor tag. So I'm using ahref. And here we will put one icon. So just copy any icon code and write it here. So this is the first icon. So I will change it to Facebook. Let's duplicate it. And the second one is Twitter. Now the third one is LinkedIn. And next one is Instagram. Now just copy this class name social icons. Write it here. Then I am adding right 72 pixel. bottom 35 pixel and position absolute. Now you can see all these icons in the right bottom corner. Now just copy this one. After that we will write UL and LI. So list style it will be none. Margin top 15 pixel and text align center. Reload the web page and you can see all these icons over here and good space between these icons. Now just copy it again, then write A for anchor tag. Here we will add color and we'll add one border radius 50% and border it will be 1 pixel solid and this color, padding 5 pixel, display block, that's it. Reload the web page and you can see very beautiful social media icon on this web page. So this is how you can easily create this kind of attractive web page using HTML and CSS. I hope this video will be helpful for you. If so, please hit the like button and also subscribe my channel Easy Tutorials. Thank you so much for watching this video.